Hi there. Let's talk about tasks by planner. This is part of Microsoft 365, and it's a worthwhile application looking at. Let's start by having you understand the basics of what it is and what it can do, and then you can figure out how to apply it to your world. So task by planner, I would say, is like the ultimate task management tool for yourself, for all the to-dos you have, for your actual team that you work with. It's a great way to manage tasks and also to delegate and share information with other people. So let me show you this environment so you can get a feel for what it looks like. So here you see Tasks by Planner within the Microsoft Teams environment. You can use it here, or you can use it on the web as an app by itself, for yourself, or shared with a group. It can be part of SharePoint. It can just be part of your Microsoft 365 family of products. Okay, so let's see, show you how you can get planners showing up here. So if you have a team that you work with and you want to share information and share tasks, then the best way to do that is to bring in this application. So we're going to go to the plus sign at the top of your team's channel, and then you can type in the search task by planner or tasks or planner. If you don't find it for some reason, go to more apps and you should find it easily in there. I happen to have it showing up right at the top here just because I use this a lot, bring it into a lot of my teams, so it's showing in the forefront. So if I click on this, so the first thing it asks me is if I want to create a new plan, and that's what we're going to do. But you can also bring in an existing plan. So if you made a plan already, maybe you did it on the web app, or maybe you did it through SharePoint, then you can take that plan and bring it into the team so you're sharing it with the rest of the team. So I'm going to create a new plan, and let's say my plan involves a project that I need to do with the instructors. We need to recruit some more instructors for some of the training, so we have a lot of tasks around that. So I'm going to not just name this tasks. It's a good idea to have something beyond that so you can tell the difference between this task plan and another one that you might create. So I'll just say instructor recruitment. I do abbreviate so I don't take up too much room at the top. Okay, so I have a blank slate to work from. You saw that I was actually on an existing plan before, so I'm just going to peek at that one again to show you what that could look like, and then we're going to add a couple of tasks here, and then we're going to go into the web app, take a look at it from that angle. So let's go back to the one I already had. So this planner is all about tasks that we need to complete as instructors. So maybe we have notes to complete, we have examples to complete, we have questions to answer. So you see those are the headings, which really are what's called the buckets of tasks that we have. And then under those headings, we have a number of items with dates on them, people's names that are assigned to them, and all kinds of extra information in them. And so we're gonna add a couple of tasks like these to our new plan. But before we do, let's take a peek at what's possible here. So I have a number of tasks here. If I click on this first one, create an example for the video, right now it's just under the to-do bucket, meaning that there is no special location for it in terms of a heading. So what I could do is where it says bucket and to-do, I can click on that dropdown and I can pick one of the ones that exist. If I wanted to have a different bucket altogether, or a different heading at the top, then I'd have to not be in a task, but add to a new bucket right on my screen there. So let's say we wanted to use create an example for video. So that's examples to create. And then we've got the option of what the progress is of that. So it's in progress, that's fine. Priority, I can change that to important. And let's say I want to start it today, and I should get it done today. And then you see you have a lot of area for other information on a task. So I'm just going to show you this stuff in another example of a task rather than typing in front of you. So let's just hit the X to go out of there. It saves as you go, by the way. There's no save button. You just hit that X. All right, so now let's go to another task I already have that has a number of bullet points or subtasks, if we want to call it that. So I'm going to click on this one, and you're going to see that this particular task has some notes already in it, and it has a checklist within it as well, and it also has an attachment in it that we can use. So a lot of different pieces here. In fact, if you go to the very bottom of a task, there's a comments area. So other people within the team can comment on your task, and it's kind of like you having a conversation about that one task. So you're keeping the conversation right to the task, so very, very specific. And when you comment on a task, that person that is working on the task will actually get an email about that comment that will link them back to this task. So that's quite cool. Let's close that. Okay, there's another task that's showing here. If I click on it, you're gonna see that this task is really, the reason it's showing like the way it is on the screen is because it says show on card. That's a little button that can be checkmarked. This one, if I checkmarked show on card for notes, then just watch how that task looks different. So I'll close that. So find out about attachments was the task. If I click on it again and choose show on card and then close it, you see how that's different, right? So lots of options here. Now let's go out of there. One more thing I'm gonna show you and then we'll make our own task together is that let's say one of these tasks was in the wrong place. We wanted to actually put it into a different bucket, let's say. We can actually just drag that task around. So click and drag. So kind of like having a bunch of sticky notes on a wall, you're just moving them around so that you know where that particular task falls. And so we are looking at this task based on the list or the bucket. Bucket's like a list. Then you could also change it to look at it based on due dates or who's assigned to stuff, all kinds of other methods of looking at your tasks. But let's go on to actually creating a new task from our new task list. So I'm gonna go over here, go to my task instructor recruitment, and I could just start typing in where it says enter a task name. I can type in, you know, call HR company to help me, and I can put a date on there. So let's say I want to do that tomorrow, and I can assign it right away to myself as opposed to somebody else. You can assign it to more than one person on your team. I'll just have it for myself. Add that task. So that adds that task with a few details in it. If I needed to add way more details, I click on the task to go into it further and I can add all the extra details. So adding a task is really easy. Now, of course, there's a lot more information we can put into that task. We can open it up again and add more to it. And if I go back to the other task list that I had where there's a number of tasks already on the go, just keep in mind there's way more ways to look at these tasks. Now, let's take a look at Planner. Task by Planner on the web so you can see how it looks from there. If you don't want to use it in Teams, you don't have to use it in Teams. You could use it just on the web as an application by itself. So let's go there. So from the web, I'm going to have you log on to your Microsoft account. Once you're logged into your Microsoft account, I want you to go to the menu, which is this waffle at the top left-hand corner. Click on that. And Planner might be showing in your list of apps right away for you. If it's not, then just go to where it says all apps and then alphabetically look through this list to find Planner under the P's. So Planner's right there. And then once you find Planner, that's where you're gonna see all the plans that you're a part of. And you're also gonna have the ability to create new plans if you want to. So you see from my screen, I'm a part of a lot of plans. I've been using this product for quite some time. I'm using it for real. I'm using it for my classes as an examples. I'm using it with my customers on teams I belong to with them. So I have a lot of plans on the go and this becomes one central place to see them all. Now I also can have my own plan. So if I didn't want to have other people see my tasks, I just want to have an area for my tasks by myself, then if I go to new plan within the web app, I'm creating a new plan just for myself. And in fact, that's what I did. So I can just show you really quick, Connie's planner. That's my new plan for me. Nobody else has seen it. And you can see at the top, it says Connie Clark. And there's no other people's names showing up here or any other indicator that somebody else is seeing this plan. So let me show you what the difference could be. So these other plans that are right underneath here are other ones that are part of a team or a SharePoint site that I've created them on. So if I click on, say, marketing planner, notice at the top that there's a number of little icons that represent other people. And it also says open in Microsoft Teams. So that's an indicator that this plan was created within Teams and that's where I can open it from instead of looking at it here. So if I go to any of these, at the very top, it's showing that indicator. Okay, and the planner we were looking at within Teams earlier is showing here on the web app. In the same way, the difference is that it's a little bit different looking in the web app. Your menus are a tiny bit different. And for the most part, you have most of the things that you could do within Teams showing up here. The extra thing you have on the web app is the background. You might be noticing I have some colorful backgrounds on my plans. Those colorful backgrounds are not showing in Teams as of yet. Maybe that will be added in the future, but right now it's just a plain white background within Teams or a gray background within Teams. If you're on the web app, you can pick your color. And how you do that is go to these three little dots and then go to your plan settings. And there's all kinds of cute little backgrounds that you can pick from. This, by the way, is also where you delete a plan. So if you made a plan in Teams and you're like, uh-oh, I don't need that plan anymore. I was just kind of goofing around trying this thing and I don't really want it. You can get rid of it out of Teams by making it disappear from there, but it really doesn't get rid of it until you delete it from the web. So you have to go into Planner on the web and then delete the plan by choosing delete this plan here. Okay, so as things happen with your plan, if you're sharing a plan with other people, just keep in mind those other people are being notified or being notified when you complete a task. They're being notified when you make a change on the task that they're working on. They're being notified when you delegate a task to them or assign a task to them. And if something is overdue, they're also being notified. So you're getting a few notifications along the way. And to control those notifications, you would go into those three dots again and into plan settings and go into notifications to control how much notifications that you get. Okay, so there's just a quick peek at what Planner looks like and how it can work for you. Hopefully it's something that you see helping you in your world of work. I think it's an amazing addition to a Teams environment and I encourage you to try it out and see how you go. All right, have fun. Bye-bye.